गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इन क्लास 10th मैथमेटिक्स द टॉपिक इज पॉलीनोमियल। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस सम इंपॉर्टेंट डिजिट्स दैट वी हैव आल्सो डिस्कस इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर दैट इज इन पार्ट टू। हियर वी विल आल्सो प्रोवाइड अ ब्रीफ रिव्यू अबाउट दिस रिजल्ट्स एंड सम क्वेश्चंस वी विल सॉल्व बेस्ड ऑन दिस रिजल्ट्स टुडे। द रिजल्ट्स आर एज फॉलोज। फर्स्ट आई हैव रिटन द रिलेशंस बिटवीन जीरोज एंड कोएफिशिएंट्स फॉर द क्वाड्रेटिक पॉलीनोमियल। If I have the quadratic polynomial px equal to ax square plus bx plus c, then there will be two zeros. Let these are alpha and beta. Then sum of zeros alpha plus beta is equal to minus b divided by a, and product of zeros that is alpha beta is equal to c divided by a. Similarly, if I am having the cubic polynomial that is ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d, then there will be three zeros, and I will get three results for a cubic polynomial. These are alpha plus beta plus gamma equal to minus p upon a. Similarly, sum of product of zeros taken two at a time is equal to c divided by a, and product of the zeros is minus d divided by a. If I have the biquadratic polynomial, then it will have the four zeros. Let these are alpha, beta, gamma, and delta. And for biquadratic polynomial, students, we will get the four results, that is sum of zeros is equal to minus b divided by a, sum of the product of zeros taken two at a time will be equal to c divided by a, and sum of the product of zeros taken three at a time will be minus d divided by a, and product of zeros I will get e divided by a. There are some more results, and these results are very important, students. It will help you in solving many problems. Like, if I am having alpha plus beta whole square equal to alpha square plus beta square plus 2 alpha beta, it is a well-known result. Then what I can do, I can transfer this 2 alpha beta to this left-hand side. Then I can get alpha square plus beta square is equal to alpha plus beta whole square minus 2 times of alpha beta. Similarly, I can find the result for alpha cube plus beta cube, which is equal to alpha plus beta whole cube minus 3 times of alpha beta into alpha plus beta. Similarly, alpha plus beta whole square minus alpha minus beta whole square is equal to 4 times of alpha beta. Students, based on these results, now we will solve some questions for you. Let us take our question. It is, if alpha beta are the zeros of a quadratic polynomial px equal to 3x square plus x plus 1, then we may be asked to find some such values like alpha plus beta. Second, I have written alpha square plus beta square. Third, 1 divided by alpha cube plus 1 divided by beta cube. Fourth one, I have written alpha square beta plus alpha beta square. Students, the basic rule you have to keep in mind to solve these type of problems, that you have to convert these values that you have to find in the form of alpha plus beta and alpha beta. Whatever the value you are given, you have to convert by applying these results in the form of alpha plus beta and alpha beta. Let's see how we have to proceed. First of all, we have to write the given polynomial. Here, given polynomial is px equal to 3x square plus x plus 1. Then we have to compare it with a standard polynomial, which is given ax square plus bx plus c. After comparing these two, I can get the values of a, b and c. Here a will be 3, as I have written, b will be 1, and again c will be 1. So after finding the values of a, b and c, I have to find sum of zeros, that is alpha plus beta, from given polynomial. Alpha plus beta, as we know, is equal to minus b divided by a. So simply I have to replace the values. So alpha plus beta comes out to be minus 1 divided by 3. Similarly, next I have to find the value alpha square plus beta square. As I said earlier, it is not the normal form. I have to convert it in the form of alpha plus beta and alpha beta. So I can use this result. Here I have written alpha square plus beta square, which is equal to alpha plus beta whole square minus 2 times of alpha beta. So I will replace this value as alpha square plus beta square equal to alpha plus beta whole square minus 2 times of alpha beta. Again, I am having alpha plus beta as minus b divided by a. I will replace the value for alpha plus beta. Similarly, I have to replace the value for alpha beta as c divided by a. Now, I will replace the values of b, a, c and a. Here, after replacing the value, the final result I am getting as minus 5 divided by 9. Similarly, other results can be converted into or in the form of alpha plus beta and alpha beta. As you can see here, the third result that I have to find was 1 divided by alpha cube plus 1 divided by beta cube. If I take LCM of this, LCM will be alpha cube into beta cube. In numerator, I will get beta cube plus alpha cube, or I can write it as alpha cube plus beta cube divided by alpha beta whole cube. So the result for alpha cube plus beta cube will be alpha plus beta whole cube minus 3 alpha beta into alpha plus beta. Students, this is an identity I have used here. Again, I can replace the values of alpha plus beta and alpha beta. As I know, these are respectively, for alpha plus beta is minus b divided by a, and alpha beta can be replaced by c divided by a, and we can solve the values and can find the final answer. Similarly, I can resolve alpha square beta plus alpha beta square. If I observe it carefully, I can find or I can take common alpha beta, then the result can be converted to in the form of alpha plus beta and alpha beta as alpha beta multiplied by alpha plus beta. Students, now we will learn one more concept today. How to find a quadratic polynomial from a given polynomial where the conditionals roots or zeros are given. Here we have to proceed in these two steps. First of all, we have to find the sum of zeros and product of zeros of the given polynomial. Then with the help of this, we have to find the quadratic polynomial Px equal to k multiply x square minus sum of zeros into x plus product of zeros. This is the formula to find a quadratic polynomial directly. Let's see an example. Students, let's see or let us discuss a question. Here, I have written one question for you. If alpha beta are the zeros of Px equal to x square plus x plus 1, then we have to find another quadratic polynomial whose zeros are 2 alpha plus 1 and 2 beta plus 1. So first of all, I will write the given quadratic polynomial, that is Px equal to x square plus x plus 1. I have written this. Let zeros are alpha and beta. From here, I will find the sum of zeros and product of the zeros of the given quadratic polynomial. Because alpha and beta here are the zeros of this polynomial, that is x square plus x plus 1. So I will write alpha plus beta as minus b divided by a. Here b comes out to be 1 and a also comes out to be 1. So final result for alpha plus beta I will get as minus 1. Similarly for alpha beta, that is product of zeros equal to c divided by a, I will get 1. Now I have to find another quadratic polynomial, but the zeros here are 2 alpha plus 1 and 2 beta plus 1. As I have discussed earlier, to find a quadratic polynomial, I will need sum of zeros and product of zeros. So to find the new quadratic polynomial, I will find the sum of zeros and product of zeros of the new polynomial. As you can see, zeros are 2 alpha plus 1 and 2 beta plus 1. So I have to find the sum of these two zeros, that is 2 alpha plus 1 and 2 beta plus 1. If I simplify the result, I am getting 2 alpha plus 2 beta plus 2. After replacing the values of alpha plus beta, here alpha plus beta I get here as minus 1. I get the sum of zeros of the new quadratic polynomial as 0. Similarly, I have to find the product of the required quadratic polynomial. After multiplying these two and replacing the value of alpha plus beta and alpha beta, the final result I am getting is 3. Now I will replace these values, that is sum of zeros and product of zeros, in my formula, which is the polynomial is equal to k times, k here is a constant, k times x square minus sum of zeros into x plus product of the zeros. If I replace the value k multiply by x square minus 0 into x as sum of the zeros of required polynomial, I get 0. So I will replace 0 for sum of zeros plus product of zeros, I get 3. So I will replace the value 3 here. After simplifying, I am getting quadratic polynomial as k times x square plus 3. Here k is a constant and it is an arbitrary constant that can take any value. So in this way I can get a quadratic polynomial. If I replace the particular value for k, then I can get a particular polynomial or say quadratic polynomial for given condition. Students.